It took a couple months and a lot more work than I planned, but we got all the way from here to here in about 6 months. After all that, the engine's no good. I'm not gonna rebuild the V6. So the Blazer sits, patiently awaiting a transplant. And then, a donor surfaces. This is a V8 Small Block 350 out of an also 1988 Chevy pickup. We immediately tear it down and clean it up. Before we can do anything else, the V6 has to come out. Two afternoons later, there it is. With the oil pan off, it's immediately obvious where the noise was coming from. So here's what we're working with. I did a lot of reading online before attempting this V8 swap, but unfortunately there's not much about the four-wheel drive models, and all this front-running gear is in the way of everything. First up, it needs an oil pan that clears the front differential. There's a couple ways to go about this, and I'm certainly not saying this is the best way or the easiest way, but what I came up with is to take the flange off the V8 oil pan and the sump off the V6 oil pan and make them one. Yeah, it's gonna need some work. We tacked together the pieces we won't be using to make an oil pan for the V6, so it can sit on a dolly in the garage. It'll probably be fine. Then we got to welding up the real oil pan. This was tough. Our Harbor Freight welder and flux core wire does not get along with the thin steel, so pretty much just stitched it together with tack welds.
Oh, there's a big hole. That one too. All right.
It's not the prettiest Frankenstein at the ball, but I think it'll work just fine. Laid on some JB weld on the outside of the pan to hopefully prevent any oil leakage. Next up, what about these mounts? I bought these Transdapt 4406 engine swap mounts for this specific year, specific truck, and four-wheel drive. It uses these brackets in the 2.8-liter style motor mounts. So here's the new engine. I'm not doing a rebuild. The truck it came out of was running just fine, and at this point, I don't really want to mess with it. In keeping with the low-budget philosophy of this truck, we're just gonna put it together and see how everything works. With the oil pan off, you can see how good the guts look. The camshaft and cylinder walls look great. It really gives some perspective to how bad that 4.3 was. I just put a standard oil filter adapter on the block. It's the stubbiest oil filter I can find, and hopefully I can get it to clear that front drive shaft. I took the taller oil pickup out of the 4.3 and tack welded it to the oil pump once I got the height set correctly. I have some concerns about how these engine mount brackets are going to fit, but we'll get to that later. There's our new oil pan. And it's just about ready to go. I checked it with both the V8 starter and the V6 starter, just in case we had to go with the smaller one. But I think the V8 starter is going to fit. So then I get to looking at the fitment of these engine mounts. Yeah, that's not gonna work. The passenger side mount is considerably higher. Now, I don't know if this has to do with being an S10 Blazer, but the kit is supposed to fit the Blazers too. The width of these mounts is off too. They're simply too narrow as they are. contacted Transdapt, and they just told me to buy a different kit. Well, the only thing to do is a test fit. This engine is a bear to get in there. Had to take off the windshield wiper motor and the studs from the water pump. That's how close this is. And now I know these motor mounts are not going to work. I did some research, looked at all my options, and figured, screw it, I'm gonna make these mounts fit. I'm kind of stubborn like that. I cut them shorter and notched the mount holes. Now it's in. It's actually sitting on the motor mounts. It's sitting a little far forward. Like this, the radiator is not going to fit. At least the mounts line up. But a new problem arises. It's too close to everything. Power steering pump is just about touching the gearbox. Oil filter is actually over top of the diff, and the block is hitting the firewall. So I had another think. Some of these problems could be solved with shorter engine mounts, but then the oil filter's hitting the diff, I'm worried about the oil pan hitting the diff, and that power steering pump and those power steering lines are not going to work. So if I'm set with this position, and I don't want to hack a big chunk out of the firewall, what else could I do? How about a body lift? Now the only kits out there are 2-inch and 3-inch, and those are both too much. I wanted a 1-inch lift. Just enough to clear this engine and maybe help clear some bigger tires in the future. So, how do you do a 1-inch body lift? I went with this 3-inch aluminum from eBay. It is the cheapest and strongest way to do this. Took these solid pucks, drilled a hole in each one, gave them a quick coat of paint. By the grace of the gods, all of the body mount bolts came out okay. They didn't all look great, but they came out, and that's what matters. I got these longer bolts to use with the extra height of the body lift. They're grade 10.9 and should be at least as strong as what the factory used. Due to some of the body panel rust, I had to resort to some interesting methods to get them all in. But everything worked out. Turned out looking pretty good too, I think. I also elongated the notches in the transmission crossmember to push everything back a little farther. I made some little spacers to get a little extra height for the oil filter clearance on the driver's side. For a distributor, I got this clear unit. It's about as 80s as it gets. I figured I could do a high-speed video of it on the channel for you guys. Maybe it's tacky, but honestly, it's kinda cool. Miraculously, it even fits. It's close, but it fits. Between the body lift and the modifications to the engine mount brackets, everything's starting to look really good. I mean, it's still a really tight fit, but this chassis wasn't made for a V8. I wouldn't call it tons of clearance, but it's definitely enough. So finally, the engine is in and bolted to the transmission. That's one huge hurdle conquered. The torque converter spacing troubled me a little bit, but I ended up using two washers between the torque converter and the flex plate. This engine actually came with two washers in that same spot. The pilot's definitely in the crank, so we're just gonna cross our fingers on that one. After a quick test fit, I changed the water pump studs to bolts to get a little bit extra space for that radiator. Now that it's all together, I can finally get it out of the garage. I bolted on the same Motorcraft 2150 carburetor I had on the 4.3 liter. It came off of a 400, so it should still be fine for this 350. In the future, I'd like to change the intake, and I already have an Edelbrock 1406 to go on it. It's really satisfying to have everything together, finally. Still not sure about changing the oil filter once there's a drive shaft and exhaust in the way. That's just gonna have to be something I work out at a future date. I actually like the look of the body lift. It's pretty subtle, except for the bumpers that fit even worse. Next up, I designed a bracket to hold both the throttle cable and the transmission's TV cable, since neither the V6 nor the V8 brackets lined up with the right lengths. Yeah, I could have bought one, but all the cheap ones I found looked pretty flimsy. Besides, it's pretty simple. finding an exhaust that would fit took a lot of research. I looked into headers, and even with ones made for the four-wheel drive S10s, saw mixed reports about how well they fit. I decided to just go for the sure thing, and what was recommended were exhaust manifolds off of a third-gen, low-power 305 Camaro. Still a tight fit, it's kind of touching the steering shaft, and the alignment of that exhaust outlet is going to make the exhaust a tricky one. But it does fit. The right side is actually off of a 305 Caprice, because that's what I was able to find. Had to take a big chunk out of this accessory bracket where there used to be an air pump in order to fit the lower radiator hose. Did I mention it's a tight fit? Eventually got it all worked out. Everything's in, fluids are filled, I think everything's connected. Not taking any chances with the upper radiator hose against the alternator again. I had a bit of a field day making the power steering lines fit, and admittedly they look a bit like a crazy straw. But they fit, and that's what matters, right? Still have to hook up the front drive shaft. When taking it apart, one of the U-joint caps came off and dropped needle bearings everywhere. Had to search for almost an hour to get them all back, but now the drive shaft is connected and that's all that matters. I had pre-lubed the engine on the stand, but to test the oil pressure numbers, I wanted to try it in the vehicle too. The drill was hitting the firewall so it couldn't get it to spin very fast, but it definitely has oil pressure. Let's see if she cranks. Sounds good. Cranking oil pressure is great too. So I ran a compression test. It's a cold engine, but some of the numbers are a bit low. I'd like to test it again in the future to see if the rings are really this worn, but this should be good enough for now. First test, fingers crossed. Aw, hell, the distributor's off 180 degrees. Let me fix that and we'll try that again. Okay, it definitely wants to run. I'm gonna push her outside and see what happens. It makes a hell of a racket with those unequal length manifolds and no exhaust, but it is running. Vacuum looks good, set the timing, did some basic tuning. Everything seems to be working just as it should. Bleed the coolant, the power steering, top off the fluids, and see if the transmission still works. That fast idle needs a little work. Sounds like a diesel tractor, but it's alive. This swap was the biggest car project I've ever attempted, so it's incredibly satisfying just to see it moving. There's still a lot of work to be done, but come on, how can a V8 S10 Blazer not put a smile on your face?
blow up.
No.
That's good. That's a good sign.